Let's talk about the aldol condensation and subsequent elimination reactions. So we begin with a ketone or aldehyde that has acidic alpha hydrogens, such as we have here. Okay, and we deprotonate those with hydroxide and thermodynamic enolate conditions, kinetic conditions to get the more kinetic, less hindered enolate versus the more stable enolate. We would use LDA and THF. Okay, and so in this particular example, we show a situation where there's only one option, so we can use the hydroxide and water. And we do a self-condensation forming a beta-hydroxy-alpha-beta ketone or aldehyde. And then sometimes, without prompting, this particular reaction will go ahead and form an alpha-beta unsaturated ketone. Other times we have to heat in acid or in hydroxide, so this is an either or, not a two-step reaction, but an either or to get to that alpha beta unsaturated ketone. We say alpha beta, we mean alpha, and there's the beta position. Okay, and so that's also could be considered the 1, 2, 3, and 4 positions there. So experimental design is very important for the aldol. If we have symmetrical aldol conditions like we do above, where our enolate forming ketone or aldehyde is symmetrical or only has one set of alpha hydrogens, then we can use hydroxide and water, do the self-condensation, so we end up with two of these, so we keep track of there's one and there's the other, so six total hydrogen or carbons. We started with 3 times 2 is 6. We need to end up with 6. Count your carbons, beta hydroxy ketone. So no problem there. One product possible, high yielding. However, if we're unsymmetrical, we have to pick whether we are kinetic or thermodynamic enolate. And so for a thermodynamic enolate, like we have here, we can use hydroxide and water because we're in equilibrium conditions. And so we will form an enolate between the more stable enolate, will form an enolate that is more stable, which is more substituted by carbon. So this side of the molecule is more stable to form the enolate by deprotonating this proton here. Okay, and so if we want the kinetic enolate, the more accessible enolate rather than the more stable, we would use LDA to completely prepare the initial enolate by adding this dropwise to a prepared solution of LDA at negative 78 dry ice acetone conditions. And so we would form an enolate that is more kinetic instead of thermodynamic because it's easier to access, and so a lower activation barrier to form that particular enolate, and then the subsequent addition. And so we add from the opposite side of the molecule in a self-condensation, again counting your carbons to make sure that you have everything in the final product. Now if we have a crossed aldol, which means we're not using a self-condensation, we've got two different things here. So we've got a ketone or an aldehyde here, and we've got a ketone here. We could inverse these if we want to make a different product, and only one of those has alpha hydrogens, then we can add very slowly to a prepared solution of the electrophile and the base, we can add the nucleophile where we want to form the enolate dropwise to this solution, so that we slowly add and deprotonate rather than self-condensation with the what we've drawn acetone here as the enolate forming ketone. It would self-condensate if we did not add it dropwise. So we want to add it dropwise here and then work up with acid so that it's easier to isolate and we get our final compound as shown. Now a crossed aldol where both have alpha hydrogens is more complicated because we have the risk of self-condensation, so we can't use equilibrium conditions. So we have to add our enolate forming aldehyde or ketone dropwise to a prepared solution of LDA and THF. And that forms the enolate irreversibly, and then that enolate adds to our electrophile that we also add dropwise in a very exothermic reaction, and then finally we do an acid workup at the end to isolate our product. Okay, and so just since we haven't done it yet, the enolate formed to completion by LDATHF, and then it adds to our electrophile in the following manner. And then you see the product that is formed here, and we can mark which carbons belong to which species. Okay, so those carbons belong here, and then these carbons belong here, and then we need to mark in where our aldehyde methyl group there. We use benzaldehyde in the last example, and so there we have our two carbons from the aldehyde, three carbons from the ketone. Count them up, make sure you're not missing any. So let's look at the full mechanism of the aldol reaction. And so we are going to start highlighting here. A symmetrical aldol will start via deprotonation to form the enolate. Okay, since it's a self-condensation, we have more of these hanging around, more acetone molecules hanging around, so we can then close the enolate, attack the electrophile, and now we have a ketone, three carbons from that, then we have the OH or the O minus that we just formed, and then two more carbons from the other ketone. So we got to make sure we end up with six carbons, and then at this point we can treat this with H3O plus or any aqueous acid, irreversibly, a nice acid-base reaction that will form our beta hydroxy ketone. So there's alpha, there's beta, and we've got the beta hydroxy ketone. We said that we can choose here. We can choose to work this up in acid or base with heat, a little bit of heat here. So if we use acid and heat, we've got more acid floating around, so we heat this. Well, let's take our compound and grab, let's highlight a bond here on H3O plus, and let's protonate this alcohol. Okay, so some of the time this will be protonated. And we form a good leaving group in water. And then we can use solvent. So this is equilibrium here. Here's equilibrium. We can use solvent to then perform an E2 type elimination to form an alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Okay, so we follow up with the elimination here. Now, what happens if we do this in base instead? So instead of adding the workup step, instead we say, okay, well, let's use hydroxide again in water, but let's heat it this time. Okay, so instead of a workup step, we heat. And so here's a situation where we don't do an E2 elimination. We instead do what's called an E1cB elimination. And kinetically, it's a little bit different because we're instead going to deprotonate this acidic hydrogen. And the rate determining step of this reaction, the rate determining step, is the formation of that anion. And so it is a unimolecular type elimination here that we see, but it relies on the deprotonation using the base hydroxide. So it's a complicated mechanism compared to the E2 or the E1 reaction. So at this point, we will resonate up into this ketone here and form the enolate. And at this point, a water molecule will be floating by, and so it is involved in the mechanism here. They've proven this to be part of the mechanism, and so we have this elimination that occurs, pairing off to form a water in situ as you go, and we get the same compound. We get the alpha beta unsaturated ketone through a different mechanism in base. So in base it's E1cB, in acid it is E2 elimination.